Jermaine and Sarah Luciano. Although he was born into a Christian family, he, in his teenage years, he was a rebellious and troublesome child, which led his parents to place him for counseling in his living center. During that time, he experienced personal encounter with the Lord and was led by the Holy Spirit into repentance and called into ministry. It was then that his spiritual growth began, a growth that has not stopped even until now. In his early 30s, he was ordained as an evangelist and grew to become a spiritual speaker, a leader that he is now. Pastor Joe Luciano, Joe, as most people call him, has traveled to preach the Word of God in Puerto Rico, New York, Texas, Mexico, where he also conducted revival services. His heart is to strengthen and equip ministers and congregation to have a strong impact in the world for Christ. Pastor Joe and his wife are now ordained pastors at Koinonia Christian Fellowship, which is a small church located at 5023 Rain Avenue in the northeast of El Paso. Together they work to teach, feed, and guide the lost and hungry souls into the kingdom of God. Pastor Luciano also is volunteered his time, and you know, when my mom was at Sierra Providence East, I see Pastor Luciano's picture there as the one of the Volunteer of the Year awardee. Pastor Luciano, every morning he has a program praying for people over Facebook. That he has a lot of followers. Pastor Luciano gonna deliver the Word of God to us tonight, and then he is the one that came to my heart to deliver that word. When we see the situation that all the Haitians going through today, let me welcome Pastor Joe Luciano here.
Amen. Praise God. Amen. Amen. You could continue worshiping God. Amen. God, thank the Lord.
Merci, mon Dieu.
For the mighty work that he's doing.
Pour la belle affaire.
When the pastor asked me to come and share,
le pasteur est venu et puis m'a dit pour.
Automatically, I went to online to study and know about Haiti.
Pour partager, il est venu et puis il venait étudier de Haïti.
Looking at the pictures.
Le regard des photos, yo.
It brought tears in my eyes.
Il était venu crier.
The only thing you see is tents.
C'est un bagage ouais, c'est bagage triste.
No homes.
And
it broke my heart. You can imagine how God's heart is broken.
Yes.
Yes.
But I've come to bring you some good news.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I've come to bring you some good news, I say. Hallelujah. I thank God for my sister Jenny. You can stand up and say hi.
Yeah.
And my wife couldn't come. So I ask you to keep her in prayer.
Amen.
I don't
know about you. I feel the Holy Spirit.
Yeah.
feel the anointing of the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Yes, amen.
Yes, Lord.
I was just encouraged.
Amen.
I was moved. With his brother.
Avec Flemna.
A survivor.
Qui un monde qui ouais ça t'est passé
dans ta vie.
Qui là?
As a testimony.
Comme un testimony, un témoignage.
That God could restore.
Yes.
Que mon Dieu qu'a restauré.
Yes.
He could have gone to the world.
Yes.
He could have gone to the world.
Il était allé dans la mort.
He could have gone drinking.
Il était allé boire.
He could have partied.
Il était allé fêter.
Yes.
But he's here.
Mais il est là.
Amen. He's here today. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. But I want to talk to you, and I'm going to make it as quick as possible. But I want to do something different. And if I say it wrong, please forgive me. I spent a whole week.
Yes. Yes.
Pastor, a whole week.
Yes.
Learning Creole.
Yes. Yes.
Oh my God.
Yes.
And I'm here listening.
Et puis là, l'attendez.
Reading.
Reading.
I said, Lord Jesus, help me.
Yes.
So you can help me out if I make a mistake. Terry Poo.
Map.
I am praying for Haiti.
La prière pour Haïti.
And guess what? I'm Haiti. I'm Haiti. We are Haiti.
Nous sommes
Haiti. Will live forever. Haiti will live forever. Doesn't matter where it goes, they're gonna live forever. God is God of Haiti. Amen. Oh, glory be to God. Let's open to the book of Romans. Amen. Chapter 8. Romans chapter 8.
Romans chapter 8.
And verse 31 through 39. Romans chapter 8, verse 31 through 39. This is what the Lord put on my heart to share with each and every one of you. Romans chapter 8, verse 31 through 39. And when you have it, you can say amen.
Amen.
We read, what then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? If who did not spare his son, but gave him up for us all, how would he not also be grateful for gratitude, given all things? Who shall bring any charge against God's elect? It is God who justifies. Who is to condemn? Jesus Christ is the one who died. More than that, he was raised, who is sitting at the right hand of God, who indeed is intercessing. I want you to put a line on it, on that word intercession. Highlight it. Intercessing. That means there's somebody praying for you. There's somebody standing in the gap for you, and that's Jesus. He's interceding for you. Verse 35, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? Shall tribulation, or distress, or persecution, or famine, or nakedness, or danger, or the sword. As it is written, for your sake we are killed all the day long. We are regarded as sheep in the slaughter. Word of the Lord.
Qui s'en a dit encore sous point ça? Si bon Dieu pour nous, qui est-ce qui car contre nous? Il peut même refuser nous pour petit lit, à même lui bail lui pour nous tous. Qui j'en pour pata ban nous tout bagage avec petit là? Tout pour grand merci. Qui moun qui va accuser nous moins moun bon Dieu choisir? Personne. Parce que c'est bon Dieu même qui fait yo grâce. Qui moun qui ka condamné yo? Personne. Parce que Jésus-Christ est mort. Ça qui pire encore, il est levé sorti vivant dans la mort. Et puis il chita sous bon droit bon Dieu côté la plaie pour nous. Qui ça a tort qui va faire nous perdre le Christ là gain pour nous? Souffrance qu'a fait nous enseignant carcéré, enseignant persécution, enseignant gangou, misère, goût, danger, la mort. D'après ça, écrit dans le livre là. C'est peut-être tout le monde. Yo sorti pour tout nous. Yo gardé nous tant pour mouton, y'a mené l'abattoir. Mais sous tout bagaille ça, yo, nous gagnons bataille là. Net. Allez, grand merci, moun qui remène nous. Parce que moi, gagne la raison, en y'a pas qu'à faire. Nous perdons le même Christ là, bien pour nous. Ni la mort, ni la vie, ni les anges, bon Dieu, ni l'autre autorité à pouvoir qui est dans le ciel là, ni bagaille qui la jetée, ni ça qui vient pour venir pita, ni pouvoir qui en haut dans le ciel là, ni pouvoir qui en bas terre. Non, pas rien. Dans toute création, bon Dieu, à qui a jamais fait nous perdre, mais bon Dieu, fait, ouais, dans Jésus-Christ, Seigneur, nous.
Amen.
Amen. And let me give you the best part of this scripture. Verse 37, all the way from 37-38. It says this.
Puis, belle partie qui est dans la Bible, c'est jusqu'à 37, jusqu'à 38.
And he said, know that in these things we are more than conquerors through him who loved us. For I am sure that neither death, life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor power, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Dans verset 37 jusqu'à 38 dit, même sous toute bagaille ça yo, nous gagnons bataille. Net allé. Grand merci moun qui remet nous hein, parce que moi gagne la raison en rien pas qu'à faire nous perdre le Christ là. Pour nous, ni la mort, ni la vie, ni les anges, mon Dieu, ni l'autre autorité à pouvoir qui est dans le ciel là, ni bagaille qui l'a jodien, ni ça qui vient pour venir plus tard.
Amen. Amen.
Amen.
And my text, if I want to use a text, I will take verse 37.
Et si tu prends verset, tu prends verset 37.
And I title it More Than Conquerors.
Et puis il t'a dit, verset ça, c'est
nous
plus que nous qui avons gagné bataille.
En Spanish, c'est más que vencedor.
Amen.
are more than conquerors. First of all, I'd like to thank the pastor.
Merci, pasteur.
And his wife and his children and the church.
Merci, pasteur, madame, pasteur, avec tout le monde qui dans l'église.
And mama.
Amen. Et maman.
May God bless her always.
Mais bon Dieu bénisse nous chaque jour.
As I mentioned, I saw the article in CNN.
Li web qui était passé dans nouvelle CNN.
And I read, and it broke me, like I said.
Et puis nouvelle a crasé li, j'en ai dit un.
I always believe.
Li toujours quoi?
What does not break you will make you.
Ça pas crasé a fait.
Amen.
Amen.
And sometime in our life, we find that we don't, like the brother was saying, that was singing, he was saying something. He says, a lot of people asking, where is God? God was there. God was there protecting. But sometimes we ourselves put ourselves in the predicament.
Mais nous-mêmes, des fois, nous mettons corps dans une situation.
In Romans chapter 8.
Dans Romains chapitre 8.
Chapter 22 and 23.
Chapitre 22 avec 23.
It says this. For we know that the world, the whole creation, have been groaning together to the pain of childbirth unto now. And not only creation, but we ourselves, we have the first fruit of the Spirit groaning inward. So we wait earnestly for the adoption as sons and the redemption of our bodies.
Et puis ça par lui-même seulement. Nous-mêmes, tout qui recevons Saint-Esprit, bon Dieu, à tout premier cadeau, bon Dieu fait nous, hein, n'a poussé gros soupir dans quel nous. Pendant n'a ton bon Dieu fin fait nous tourner petit lit net. Fin de livrer corps nous, parce que bon Dieu délivre nous-mêmes. Nous-mêmes n'attendons toujours. Si nous voyons ça, n'attendons là, nous pas n'attendons encore. Qui veut capoter tant ça l'a déjà. Même si n'attendons ça, nous pas ouais n'attendons ni avec patience.
Amen. So even the earth is crying out for redemption.
Même la terre crie.
How many of you here today are waiting for the rapture of the church?
Yes.
How many believe there's going to be a rapture of the church?
Yeah.
Can somebody say amen?
Amen.
How we are eager and desiring to leave this earth.
Yes.
I don't know about you, I got tired getting pain on my back. I don't know about you, but I am getting tired of getting migraine headaches.
Yes.
Yes.
But the Bible says it's going to be a day and a moment.
Yes.
And
the twinkling of an eye.
No.
You know what's a twinkling of an eye? Just close it on the eye. That quick.
Yes.
That the dead in Christ shall rise up first. And those that remain will be called up to meet the Lord in the air.
Amen.
So I don't know about you, but I'm waiting for the rapture of the church.
Amen.
I'm eager and desire to leave this earth.
Yes.
But guess what? The earth is crying out to God also.
Yes.
Just want to remind you, we came from the dirt.
Yes.
So if we cry, Hosanna, and we cry to be in the presence of God.
Si nous crions pour nous entrer dans la présence bon Dieu.
How much more the earth is crying out? Because of sin. Because of sin.
Parce que péché.
The world, the earth is crying out.
Yes.
La terre crie tout.
So what we see is the consequences of our sin.
Ça nous voit ses conséquences péché nous.
Et vous ne believe me.
Sur quoi comme?
Read Genesis chapter 3.
Lis premier.
Chapter 3.
Genèse 3.
It will show you that the Bible says we all have sinned and come short of God's glory. And guess what? God wants to restore. God wants to make new. What happened 8 years ago? January 12, 2010.
Janvier 12, 2010.
A devastating earthquake.
Tremblement de terre qui était passé.
Took many lives.
De prend pile la vie.
Which we have here survivors.
Mais qu'on a nous gagné qui était vive par là.
And we are here.
Et puis nous là.
To pray.
Pour prier.
To pray for you.
Pour prier pour.
That what you have lost.
Mais
God will multiply.
Amen.
The pain that you went through.
Tristesse.
The sadness.
Tristesse.
The tears that you cried. God's taking it in His hand. He's taking it and giving back blessings. You are going to walk in the blessings of God. And when somebody asks you, why are you happy? Because Jesus lives in my heart. I've been forgiven.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. So let's remember Haiti.
Amen.
Not as crying. Because we have hope.
Yes.
The world don't have hope. But we have hope in God.
Yes.
That God will work things out.
Yes.
Romans chapter 8.
Romans chapter 8.
And verse 28.
Verse 28.
It says this. Romans 8, 28. It says, and we know that for those who love God, all things work together for good. For those who are called according to His purpose.
Tant seulement nous connaissons ça bien. Dans toute bagarre, mon Dieu a travaillé pour bien. Tout le monde qui l'aimait pour bien. Tout le monde lui a fait l'idée de l'aimer. Parce que moi, bon Dieu te connaît depuis d'avance, pour moi, parle-yo depuis d'avance. Tout lui te mette-yo à part pour yo te capable de sembler à petit lia. Comme ça, petit ça, à penser pour premier petit, non, yon bon frère. C'est comme ça, bon Dieu relève tout moun lui. Te mette à part depuis d'avance. Li fait yon grâce et puis li fait grâce yon. Li ba yon louange tou.
So there is a purpose that these things happening.
Yon raison tout bagay sa yon fait.
We don't know what is the purpose.
Nous pas kon pou ki raison.
One thing we do know.
Mais on ba yon nou konnen.
That we are children of God.
Yes.
Nous se petit bon Dieu.
Amen.
God is by our side.
Bon Dieu avec nous.
Many of you know last year. September 20th,
2017.
Hurricane Maria, category number 4.
Cyclone Maria, category 4. C'est passé en Puerto Rico.
wind of 150 miles per hour.
Avec un vent gros.
The eye of the storm.
Non, je suis comme là.
Hit the little small island of Puerto Rico.
Frappé Puerto Rico.
Even unto this day, they are still suffering.
Même pour qu'on y aille, ils toujours à souffrir.
So I know what is it to lose loved ones, and I know what the storm could do. But guess what I heard? I heard that Jesus commanded a storm and says, "Peace, be still."
Amen.
I heard Jesus say, I don't know what you heard, but I heard Jesus say. And that's what counts, what Jesus said. He said, "Be still."
Yes.
Another translation, it means shut up.
Yes.
We got to tell our storm, shut up.
Yes.
Amen. Because he has given us authority. And what the devil wants to do, God turn it around. For his glory.
Amen.
And my heart goes out for those that don't have Jesus.
Amen.
And many people was lost. As you know, we don't pray to the dead. We only pray to the living. So we want to pray for those who are here today. Because prayer makes a difference.
Yes.
Amen.
And my last scripture. The book of Joshua, chapter 1. Chapter 1, verse 9.
Verse 9.
Amen. Joshua chapter 1 and verse number 9. Thank God for the iPhone. Okay, it says, "Have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened. Do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go."
Changez la mouette et baroua. Mettez garçon sourd. Pas jamais découragé. Changez la mouette et baroua. Mettez garçon sourd. Pas jamais découragé. Pas besoin de temps. Trembler, ou pas besoin de paix parce que Seigneur, mon Dieu, ou là, a toujours campé là avec ou côté ou passé.
Joshua had to confront something in his time, and God reminded him.
José, t'es gomba et t'as pensé, bon Dieu, t'es fait changer encore.
As he commanded Joshua to be strong, we need to be strong.
Amen.
Amen.
Now you know, people of God. The news.
Nouvelle.
The internet.
Internet.
Will try to make this look ugly.
And
quick to point fingers.
Et puis à longer le web.
But we know as people of God that God is still in control.
Amen.
And God is going to work things out in our benefit. It's not time for us to turn our back from God. It's time to look forward to God. And whatever you're going through today, people,
never stop passing,
you are more than conquerors.
ou plus passé
moun ki gen victoire.
You have victory in Jesus Christ.
Ou gen victoire nan Jésus.
Amen.
And to close.
Et pour fermer.
If you have never accepted the Lord Jesus Christ in your heart.
Sou pa di jam aksepte Jésus-Christ nan kè ou.
I'm not telling you about joining a church.
Bamdou pou vini nan l'église.
I'm not telling you to shake a preacher's hand.
Bamdou pou souke ou mè an prêche.
I'm talking about do you know that you are forgiven from your sin.
Mabdou kon sa, bon Dieu pardonne pou péché.
Amen.
If you have received the Lord Jesus Christ in your life.
Et vous recevoir Jésus-Christ dans la vie.
If you have not.
Sou pas.
You can receive him today.
Okay, c'est bon aujourd'hui.
Amen.
So he will take your burdens.
La pointe de bagage.
The Bible said, cast your care upon the Lord, for he cares for you. So anyone here today want to receive the Lord Jesus Christ in their heart? As a brother, a perfect example. If you never had the Lord Jesus in his heart, where would you be? When I saw him with the children in worship, I'm saying, my God, I wish the church could be like that.
Amen.
When they go through trials and tribulations, I hope the church will learn from this man of God. Without questioning God, to God, you give and you take away. Bless your name
forevermore.
If you want to receive the Lord Jesus Christ, you could receive him today. The Bible said, what profit of man if he gains the whole world? And lose your own soul.
Ki profi ki nan le moun, ki bagay tout bagay ki nan la vi? Ki sa ou moun genye ki se bagay Jezi?
Amen. If you gain everything, you lose your life.
Sou genye tout bagay ou perdi la vi?
Why are you going to profit?
Ki sa ou genye?
There's a lot of people that have everything and they're not with us today. I live my life in New York City. I went to Rockefeller Center. I went to the Empire State Building. A lot of people are rich. But they died without Christ. And someday they're going to stand before God. We are going to stand before God. And God is recording this moment. God is recording it when you stand before Him. And He'll show you His 100,000 feet screen TV. And when he tells you, what did you do with Jesus I gave you? You may not have nothing to say. But God said, play the videotape. He's going to remind you this day. Have you received the Lord Jesus Christ in your heart? It's important, people. We are living in the last days.
Yes, amen.
Don't be earthbound, be heavenbound.
Amen.
Seek the kingdom of God.
Amen.
And his righteousness. And all these other things shall be added unto us. So the altar is open.
Kunya.
Jesus Christ.
Pour recevoir Jésus Christ.
I'm gonna give you a few minutes. If you want to receive the Lord Jesus Christ in your heart, I want you to take Jesus home with you. Amen.
Amen.
If there's nobody, I want to pray. Anyone here today? Anyone today that wants to? Watch prayer.
N'importe où qui l'a la prière.
I want to pray for you.
Moi je voulais prier pour vous.
Mama, Papa, I want to pray for you.
Mama, Papa, moi je voulais prier pour vous.
You may need a healing. You may want a healing.
Ou qu'a voulu guérison.
Healing in your emotion.
Guérison ça qui n'a qui est là pour.
God is here in the name of Jesus Christ.
Bon Dieu là, le nom Jésus Christ.
And I'm going to pray for you.
Amen.
Amen. As the brother leads worship,
amen.
God has a promise for you. Like I said, the Holy Spirit is moving in the midst of us.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Holy Spirit, thank you. We thank you and welcome you, Holy Spirit, in this place.
Nous remercions pour Saint-Esprit qui nous a placé.
Alléluia. Church, I just want you just to worship God.
L'Église, moi, je veux pour
worship. Just worship your God. Worship your God today.
Pour adorer mon Dieu fort.
Alléluia. Holy Spirit, have your way to work. Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Saint-Esprit, gain fort.
Thank you, Holy Spirit.
Merci, Saint-Esprit.
The Ruah of God is here. The Holy Spirit is here. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. I want us to stand up and just worship God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Just worship God today. Hallelujah. There's people life in the balance. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We worship you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. If possible, those people that, the people of God of Haiti, I want you to come up. I want to pray for you especially. Amen. Everybody from Haiti. Because when we lay hands on you, we will send the Holy Spirit to the island, to the land of Haiti.
Hallelujah.
We thank you, Father. Hallelujah. We give you the praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We want to break every generation curse in the name of Jesus. We come against every spirit of witchcraft, of voodoo, black magic. We come against it in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. We will break every generation curse, every third, fourth, and fifth generation. We want to break it today in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you. We thank you, Holy Spirit. We thank you. Oh, the Ruah of God is here. The Holy Spirit of God. We thank you. We thank you, Father. Look upon your people, oh God. Look upon your people. I want you to stretch your hands over this way. Amen. And speak. Speak deliverance. Speak healing. You get the word of God in your mouth. You speak the word right now in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah. We thank you, Father. We give you the praise, Lord. We give you the praise, my God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be your name, Lord God of Israel. Father, I ask you right now. I ask you, Lord, I'm just a servant, oh God. I ask you, mighty God and Heavenly Father, I ask you the people that stand before here. Father, Haiti is before you now. Each person, almighty God, who is here today, they are standing in the gap for Haiti, oh Lord. You said, if my people who are called by my name will humble, repent, and turn from their wicked way, then I will hear from heaven and I will heal their lands. Heal Haiti, O God. Heal Haiti. Oh, Father, bring miracles to the government of Haiti in the name of the Lord Jesus. In the name of the Lord Jesus. And we plead the blood of Jesus upon Haiti in the name of Jesus, Lord God. Father, bless your people. Bless the land of Haiti, Almighty God. In the name of the Lord Jesus, O God. We come against every, oh my God, we come against every familiar spirits, oh God. We come and break every, oh Lord God, every spirit that's not of you, oh God. Father God, we come against them in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father God, we thank you, Lord, that you're breaking generation curse in the name of Jesus Christ. You're breaking, oh Lord, anything, Almighty God, is in the past. Father God, because this is a year of new beginning, oh God. This is a year of new beginning that you are doing, oh Lord, for the people in Haiti, Almighty God. You are going to restore Haiti. You're going to bring revival in Haiti, oh God. You will lift the pastors and evangelists, missionaries there in Haiti, oh God. Haiti will be known by the power of God in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Father, I thank you. I thank you and I praise you, my God, for hearing our prayer, Lord. I thank you, mighty God, for Pastor Jacob, oh God, and his beautiful wife, and his children, and his church. Continue blessing them here, mighty God, in the name of Jesus, oh Lord. Let your light shine in this place, in this house. Father, that your worship and your praise and the truth of your gospel may be preached and not compromised, oh God. Preach and not sugarcoat it. Preach with authority, oh God. Father, bless this church. Bless Walk by Faith Church, oh God. Bless them, oh God. Increase their numbers, oh Lord God. That, Father, that they will not even have room in this place, oh Lord. In the name of Jesus. Bless the worship team. Bless every children. Bless every boy and every girl, every man and every woman. Bless them today, oh my God. We give you the praise, honor, and glory forever. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Father, bless them, O Lord, today. Bless their finance. Bless their finance, mighty God. Their property. Bless them today, O Lord. Father, open the windows of heaven and pour down blessings upon their life and their family, O Lord. I thank you, Father. I thank you, my God. In Jesus' name, amen.
Praise God, praise God. So every day when we listen to the news, we hear of disasters, fighting, and wars. Most of us have been through a major disaster, but there are crises that can affect us personally and are within the reach of our extended family, within our city and our nation. On January 12th, 2010, there was a major disaster that occurred in Haiti at 2:53 p.m., which the congregation gathered and did a moment of silence at the exact time today, 2:35 p.m. As Mark, from the group who was performing earlier, he mentioned why do these things happen? After they did the music, the brother Mark, he came and he gave his powerful testimony about being a survivor. After Pastor Mark came up, Pastor Jose, he said he has come today to share the good news. And God will restore. One of the things that he said, God will restore. And another thing he said was, I am Haiti. I am Haiti. So, now at this exact moment, I ask, why? Why am I Haiti? Because when Haiti experienced the devastating earthquake, God, who came in the form of family and friends, to bring comfort to one another. God came in the form of nurses and doctors to heal the wounded. God came in the form of civilians, just like you and I, to help one another. Again, why am I Haiti? Because now, God has come in the form of you. Amen. To pray to allow God to continue to help one another, to continue to bring comfort to the survivors, and to pray to allow God to heal the people of Haiti's heart. Amen. Amen. Can I please have everybody bow your heads and close your eyes, please? And dear Heavenly Father, we come to you in the name of Jesus. We just want to thank you, God, for this beautiful, beautiful service that you have blessed us with today, Father God. Thank you so much for allowing people inside the church to sing and being able to play instruments, Father God, and having that opportunity to open up the floodgates of heaven, God, to allow this church be filled with the Holy Spirit. We thank you, God, for Mark giving his testimony, Father God, and we also pray for the other six survivors that also have their testimony as well. We also thank Jose for coming and preaching, Father God, and sharing that good news. I just pray, Father God, that today you brought us here safely and that after this service, you would take us home safe. Amen. Let's continue to pray for one another as we did tonight. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Amen.
We have some refreshment on the back. Any of you that need some refreshment, I know you do. You all do. And it's gonna be on the left. We got soda, we got coffee, and we got some Haitian pastry. So we all can eat. God bless you.
Gracias.
Thank you.